Are you looking for a way to live stream games on StreamYard? Well, today I'm going to show you how to do it. So let's get to it. If you're always looking for tools, tips, and tricks that can help make you a better YouTuber, subscribe to the channel and click that bell so you know when we have new content that comes out. Most of the content on this channel is all about live streaming, and a lot of you may be wondering, why don't I ever live stream? Actually, I live stream every day. It's on a channel called The Worst Gamer on Earth, and it's exactly what it sounds like. If you're interested in interacting with me or maybe asking a question or two about some of my videos, feel free to stop by. I'm always willing to stop bad gaming in order to answer your questions. I'll leave a link at the end of the video and in the description to the channel if you want to come by, hang out with me, and check it out. Here in the computer, I just do a Google search for StreamYard. Then I click on StreamYard. It takes me to the website. If you've never used this before, it's pretty easy to log in. They're just going to help you set up an account. I think there's some sort of verification through your email, and then you're ready to go. Once you're in, you're going to see broadcasts and destinations on the left-hand side. If you click on destinations, you can click on the button to add a destination. You're going to add your YouTube channel in here. You just select YouTube. It's going to ask you to log in and do all that sort of stuff so that it has permissions to use your YouTube account. Next, we're going to create a broadcast and just select which channel you want to broadcast to if you have more than one. Then you put in your title, your description, and set the privacy of your stream. If it's set to private, obviously no one will be able to see it. Unlisted means you can share out the link with other people and they can come and watch it, but it's not going to be listed by YouTube. And public means it'll be listed by YouTube. So if you select public, you can click the schedule for later, and this adds some scheduling options, but it also gives you the ability to add a thumbnail. Click on upload a thumbnail, browse to the thumbnail, select it, click apply. Now you have a thumbnail. Now you can just put down the time you want to schedule your live stream and click create broadcast. Then I click this little gear button for cam and mic. I select my face cam or whatever camera I'm using. You can actually have all kinds of different camera options in here. You can see its highest resolution is 720, so select the highest you can do. In audio, just select your audio device. And once you have all this stuff selected, you just click the X in the top right, and then you can go ahead and enter the broadcast studio. Once you enter the broadcast studio, you're gonna see your camera down in the bottom left. You can just click on that to add it to the broadcast. Next, we're going to add our game screen. So just go down here into share screen and click through the share screen option. Then we're going to select application window. In this case, I'm going to select PS4 Remote Play, and there you go. You can see it's on the screen. Now, in order to get this so it shows up properly without all of the bar at the top and all that kind of stuff, you just maximize the window, and then you Alt-Tab on a computer or Control-Tab on a Mac so that that screen is maximized, but you can still go in and mess around with other aspects of the computer, and there you go. You can see that the screen is maximized. I can see everything I need to see, and I don't have the name of the box at the top or anything like that. You can select different layouts right below the preview screen. You have one where you can display just the game. I can display me larger next to the game. I can select me small next to the game. Now, this will work if you want to add a game that's running physically on your computer as well. I'm running a Mac. Mac doesn't run many games. So I really don't have much, but I'll show you how to do it anyways. I click share screen again. I go to application menu. I just select my game screen. In this case, I have the chess game loaded on here. We'll load that up. And once again, I want to maximize it because I don't want to see that name at the top of the screen there. You see where it tells me what the name of the screen is? I don't want that. So I'm going to go ahead and maximize the chess game. And then I'm going to Alt-Tab or Control Tab, so I can go ahead and move out of that screen and into StreamYards, and then you can see that it's maximized. I don't have any of the screen name or anything at the top. And with this one, you can once again go ahead and set up the layout that you want right below the preview window. It's really that easy to stream your games with StreamYard. Now, there are certainly a lot of functionality that you don't have that you would have in OBS, but if you're just looking for a super easy way to stream a game and communicate and have fun with your audience, StreamYard might be the way to go. If you want to know how StreamYard stacks up against OBS Studios, check this video out right here. And if you're always looking for tools, tips, and tricks that can help make you a better YouTuber, subscribe to the channel. My name is Michael Fire Jr. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.